Today, I'm going to be showing you guys the two main types of cube UV unwraps that you will probably use in Blender. One of them is made using the process of UV unwrapping, and another one is created much quicker. First though, in order to see what our UV looks like, we're first going to need to left click our object to select it, and then I'm going to come to the top left hand corner of the 3D viewport, which is this menu here, and where the cross appears, I'm just going to left click and drag, and that's going to pull out another 3D viewport. Like any menu, you can change this by left clicking the button in the top left hand corner to change the editor type. I can then change it from 3D viewport to UV editor. This here is our UV window, and this will show us our UV. Right now we can't see it because we need to go into edit mode first. So I'm going to come back and move my mouse over to the 3D viewport where my cube is and press tab to go into edit mode. By default everything will be selected, but if you haven't got anything selected just press A, and now you can see we can see our UV here. This here is the default UV, and it's the one that we would usually make using the UV unwrapping process. Before I explain what this UV is good for, I'm going to show you how to make it, because this will be important for UV unwrapping other objects that have a cube-like shape. First though, I'm going to mess it up. So back in edit mode, I press A to select everything, then I'm going to press U, and think of it as U for UV unwrapped menu. And here we've got a few different options. I'm just going to choose this project from view to just use a totally incorrect UV for this example. As some of you will know, UVs are used for a variety of different texturing processes, and that's why UV unwrapping is relevant in the first place. I'm going to press 2 to go into edge select mode, and I'm going to just start selecting some edges. The edges I select here, I'm going to create a seam on. All a seam is think of it as like cutting through the edge with a scissors to create a 2D form of our shape in the UV window here. If I right click and choose mark seam, then press A, U, and then unwrap. Right now we'll have nothing because I think this is a little bit too difficult for Blender to calculate. But you can see if I now left click this edge here, maybe shift left click this one, right click mark seam, and then press A for all, U, and then unwrap. You can see it's now starting to flatten out the cube. You can see this face here that we've added the free edges to has been nicely separated from the object. But we don't want to add cuts everywhere. This goes into why we want this cross shape in the first place, and not just a bunch of squares. The cross shape will allow us to reduce the amount of seams when using just a basic square texture like this. This is important if you're downloading 4K PBR textures from online or something similar. However, what this isn't relevant for, or not as relevant at least, would be texture baking and texture painting. I'll explain later why these ones won't be as relevant. Although sometimes I would UV unwrap an object for doing these processes if it's complex enough and wouldn't suffice with a smart UV project, which is the other type of unwrap we'll be covering today. Now we need to figure out how to turn this cube into a cross in the UV workspace. So right now we've cut off the top face, so you could think of this face here as like a flap that's coming up. Next we want two flaps to come out from the side, so to do that we need to make two cuts here and here. So I'm going to left click this edge here and then shift left click this edge here, and you can right click, make sure you're in edge select mode for this, and choose mark seam. If you're not in edge select mode, you can also press Ctrl E to open up the edge menu. Here you can find the mark seam option as well. You can also clear seams to remove them. Now if I press A, U, and then unwrap, you can see we're getting closer to what we're looking for, but we still need to cut the cube on these two edges here. You'll notice though, if I select the edge here, it won't select it here. And if you want to do that to make it a little bit easier, you can enable this mode here, and now when I select the edge here, it selects it here also. This can be easier for a better understanding where cuts need to be made in the beginning. Select those two edges, and then I'm going to press Ctrl E this time to open the edge menu, and then choose mark seam. Then I'll press A, U, and then unwrap, and now you can see we've got our cross shape. It's upside down, but to be honest, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to press tab to go back into object mode. Another thing you'll encounter with more customized objects, like a rectangle for example, is not applying the scale. For example, if I press S and X to scale this along, then press tab to go into edit mode, A, U, and then unwrap, you can see we've still got square faces here, even though we're working with a cuboid now. So I'm going to press tab to go back into object mode, and what I actually need to do was apply the scale first. So you do this in object mode, so I'm going to press Ctrl A, which will open the apply menu, then I'm going to choose scale. Then I can press tab to go back into edit mode, A to select all again, then I can press U, and then choose unwrap. And now you can see we've got our cross shape, but this time it's got the cuboid shape we're looking for. So that's how we can UV unwrap an object using seams, which again is great for using like square textures as it reduces the number of seams. We can also use this form of UV unwrapping for more complex objects, which the next method won't work too well with, for texture baking and texture painting too. Let's get started on learning the other method. I'm just going to press X and then delete my cube. Then I'll press Shift A, and then under mesh I'm going to choose cube. This time I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode, A to select everything, then I'm going to press U, and then choose smart UV project. Here, another menu will come up, which will give us some options. I'm going to set my island margin to 0.01. The island margin is how much space there is between each square. This is important to prevent any strange overlapping, especially in different texture sizes. I'll then press OK, and now you can see we have this unwrap here. You can see all these squares are separated, so if we were to apply a basic square texture to this, there would be visible seams everywhere. Again though, if I was going to make this a cuboid, or changing the scale in any way, you need to make sure to unwrap it again by applying the scale in object mode, going back into edit mode, and unwrapping again. I briefly touched on it earlier, but this type of UV unwrap is a little bit more optimized for, first of all, texture baking, which is the process of taking a material, for example, procedural material you made, and turning it into an image texture. This will save you more time than UV unwrapping with seams, and is actually more optimized since the squares are bigger than on the cross. If you don't know what texture baking is, I do have a full free course on the subject, which you can check out in the description below after this video. Another thing we would use this type of unwrap for would be texture painting. This is because when we paint a texture in Blender, we can paint it directly onto the object, which means the seams won't be visible, since as far as Blender is concerned, there's no separation when you're painting on the object. However, if you were to paint in this menu, you may find some more issues. So if you wanted to paint in this menu here, then maybe it won't work as well. As I mentioned earlier though, although this unwrap is great for a cube, for more complex objects, sometimes you will need to do the first method of UV unwrapping with seams in order to prevent a really messy result, even with texture painting and texture baking. This is because when you UV unwrap a complex object with Smart UV Project, you can get crazy results like this. However, for this simple object, it works just fine and actually ends up being more optimal for the texture baking and texture painting process. But for example, this low poly character, which I texture painted a while back, I made sure to UV unwrap it using seams to prevent a really messy result. It can also help sometimes make everything a little bit clearer to understand what I'm painting and where, especially if you're going to pull things into another painting software like Krita, for example, which is another cool free software, but for painting. But yeah, that's like a good introduction to UV unwrapping in Blender. Today we learned the cube, but next time we're going to learn how to do a cylinder. If you're brand new to the whole materials and texturing in Blender, I do have a free course on the subject here, which you can check out on my YouTube channel. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Thank you.